Друзья, привет! Hi! Приветствую вас на канале English Galaxy. И мы с вами продолжаем наш наиважнейший плейлист «Реальный разговорный английский язык с нуля». И также параллельно как раз загружаем видео на нашем новом плейлисте «Английский язык до полного автоматизма». То есть мы с вами уже прошли несколько времен, и впереди как раз контрольная по вашим заявкам по нескольким временам сразу на канале. Ссылочки в описании. Итак, действительно, давайте поговорим про следующую тему. Значит, пожелания разные. Значит, есть также пожелание темп побыстрее. Но мы потихонечку к этому придем. Надо взять также количеством, чтобы оно потом перешло в качество. Итак, друзья мои, значит, поговорим про такую вещь, как money. Деньги. Деньги. Окей? Hi, my friends. Let's talk about money. Is it an interesting topic for you? I have some questions for you. Do you work or study? Do you have a job? Do you get money? How much money do you get a month? How much money? $300. $500. Maybe $1,000. Maybe more. It's very interesting to know it. Okay? Do you have a car? If you have a car, I have one more question. What car do you have? Expensive or cheap? What model? Okay? You see? And the last question. How much money do you want to get a month? How much money will be enough? $1,000. $3,000. Maybe $5,000. Really? And you know, my friends, we often hear these questions in our life. And when a person knows this information, he or she decides, or he or she understands, you are an interesting person or not. As for me, these questions aren't Interesting. I don't want to know how much money this person, this or that person has and gets. It isn't interesting. What will this information give me if I know? Or this person is rich, he has money, he has good and expensive clothes, he has a good job, and what? And I know that really lots of people prefer to have rich and successful friends. Friends with money. It's often the most important criteria for them, or the most important factor, criteria or factor for them when they choose friends. Okay. We often look only at material things, and we forget ordinary and simple people. Yeah, that's right. That's true. It's really so. Okay. It's important to have money, but money isn't everything. It isn't the aim of our life. People often want more and more money. If they don't have money, they're very unhappy. If they have money, they want more money, more and more, and they think and talk only about it. Poor people, really, very poor people. Okay. It's important to get money. We need to buy some things we need to pay for some things. But it's very bad when money controls us. When money controls our ideas, our thoughts, when it controls our hearts, we need to control money, but not money. Really, money shouldn't control us. We should control money. Really, what an interesting thing. Money is only paper. It's paper, but it takes such a big place in so many people's hearts. Really, I often hear when I walk in the street, different conversations only about money. Okay, enough. Stop talking about it. It's too much. It's too much. There are much more important things in our life. Okay. We need to work and get money. I also work, and if money comes, I don't say no, I don't need it. If money comes, I don't refuse. I don't refuse. But I don't start these conversations. How much money do you get? I don't say that I get, for example, $500 a month. I don't look for rich friends. I don't need it. But you know, when I see people who spend all their life on one thing, to get more and more money, I'm afraid. I'm afraid for these people. And I feel pity because life passes very quickly, and money appears and disappears. We can't take it with us, but we should find a real treasure which never disappears and which will never disappear. It's our bank. It's our bank. Some people have a small bank or small treasure. Some people have a big bank or a big treasure. And this bank is a bank of our good ideas, actions, good things which we do, and positive things, positive, not only material, not only material things. And I read some information in one very clever book that the percent in this bank, the percent in this spiritual bank is much, much, much higher than the percent in all the banks in the world put together. And this money is yours. Take this money. Okay, good. And I also remembered one story from my teaching practice. It was an English lesson, and we were studying some banknotes, and I showed a banknote, not one banknote, but maybe 5 or 10 banknotes, like $100. So maybe 5 or 10 banknotes of $100. And there was a group of students, maybe 6 or 8 people, and when they saw real money, they said, "Oh, wow, wow." Their eyes were shining. They were bright. They became very active. And one girl even took one banknote very quickly, but But what? She took it. But then she understood that money wasn't real. It looked like real money, but it wasn't real. And she was very upset. She was very sad. And this story is about our two questions. Yeah? Do you control money, or does money control you? And the second question is, what is our real treasure? What will disappear, and what will stay with you forever? More and more, with a percent, a very big percent in this spiritual bank. Thank you, my friends. Good luck.